When I first saw you, I already knew there was something inside of you. Good morning, my gun tribe. How are you guys doing? It is Sunday. I'm sitting here with the husband. He's sitting here eating some cereal because we all didn't go to bed till late, so nobody actually got up and cooked this morning. So that's pretty much. I hope you guys have a blessed Sunday. Hope you guys are doing good. This video is actually not intended with the children this morning. However, I will do a separate one later on. This one is mainly my podcast introduction, pretty much. I'm Sagara, as you guys know, the mother of the gun tribe. And, I just wanted to talk to you guys this morning about stuff, you know, something that's been on my mind heavy. Just know that what I'm saying is not intended to pretty much hurt people, downgrade people, point fingers, blame, none of that. It's just me speaking how I feel from the heart and what I'm experiencing myself. So yeah, let's get started. So today I would actually like to discuss outgrowing family and friends. Okay? I'm pretty sure a lot of you guys can relate. I'm pretty sure a lot of you guys are already going through it, have been through it, or whatever. And I keep looking down because I actually wrote down my thoughts last night because you know how you're talking and you're like, man, I forgot to say this. So that's exactly why I'm doing it. But anyway, my podcast is called Mr. Mrs. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoy and just know I love you guys. But anyway, back to the topic. I wanted to talk about outgrowing family and friends. Now, we deal with a lot of people day to day. Family, friends, co-workers, strangers, whomever. Some people are in our life for a reason. Some people are for a season. Some people are for a lifetime. Me personally, I've had people in my life that I love, like, love. Like, you are my friend to the end. I will do whatever it takes to keep you, whatever. However, you can't think like that. Because just because you think that don't mean they think that. And I've lost a lot of friends that I never thought I would lose. And some I do miss. Some I still, you know, get down about, like, dang, I miss when we used to do this. I miss when we used to do that. But you know what? God took them out my life for a reason. Everybody can't go to this next chapter in my life that is about to transpire, you know? Just like some family members. It's, to be honest, I don't stop talking to a sibling for a long period of time. We're talking now. However, it was a point in time to where we went years without talking. And, you know, a lot of people are like, oh, that's your sister, that's your brother, that's your mom, that's your dad, that's your auntie, whomever to you. You got to stop acting like that. Y'all need to get along. No. If somebody is in your life causing you pain and hurt, you don't have to deal with them. You can love them, but you don't have to deal with them. They don't have to be in your life. God is not going to punish you for you wanting to have peace in your life. Peace within yourself. You know, and that includes, you know, removing whomever and whatever at that time. He said, long as you love them. So I love everybody for free. I might not deal with you, but I love you. So yeah, sometimes we get attached to family and or friends and not realize they're not good for our mental, physical, and most importantly, spiritual health. Y'all know what I mean. Sometimes we get attached to family and friends to where our body is tired. Like, our physical body is just tired. Like, it's nothing you can do, nothing you can say that can help. All right. Sometimes with our physical, you know, like, it's the same thing as mental. Like, you're tired. Your mind's tired. Your body's tired. So there's nothing else you can really do. And spiritual health, y'all know what I mean. Y'all know what I mean. The spirits be letting you know. God be letting you know when somebody ain't good for you. Now, that's up to us whether we listen to it or not. And a lot of times, I know I'm hard-headed. I will pray that God remove people out of my life if they don't mean me no good, and then they'll be gone. Seriously. But then here I go, rekindling that friendship or family shit. Oh, sorry. Rekindling that friendship or family ship again. And, you know, I know God's probably like, you being hard-headed. Now, I'm going to do it one more time. The next time, it's on you. You know, the saying, fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me. I guess that's how I go. But some, y'all get what I'm saying. So, yeah, we have to start doing better. Seriously. And, you know, what's crazy is, it's even harder when you genuinely care and love, you know, them. That's the hard part. When you genuinely care and love someone and they hurt you or you hurt them. You know, we can't always put the blame on others. We mess up as well. Okay? I knew once people only called me when it was beneficial to them. Or it was about drama. It was my time to detach from them. Because I have so many people that I had to detach from because nobody called to see, how is your mental health? How are you today? Do you need anything? Do you need a bottle of water? I had so many people in my life that never did that. But, hey, Sagira, can you come do this for me? Can you come do this for me? Can you give me a ride? Can you give me this? Can you give me this job? Hey, can I borrow this? Can I borrow that? Hey, blah, 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 blah. Can I stay with you? You know, I done had people stay with me. I done had people, you know, I done loaned my car to. I done had people, I done did a lot of things for. And at the end of the day, I was the one hurt in the end. You cannot put your feelings to the side just to please others. So, yeah, pretty much. Watch those people who claim they're there for you and support you. Seriously. And I tell you why. I started this journey with my YouTube and my podcast. And not only YouTube, I got it on Instagram, TikTok. You know, I started this whole journey, right? And the so-called friends and family that I thought would support, nobody. None of them. None of them doing it. Seriously. The people I didn't think would support are. So I really appreciate those who are supporting me. And those who aren't, it's cool. You know why? Because what God has for me and my family will be for me and my family. Remember that, okay? And I just want y'all to know I love to see everyone win. I want everyone to win and succeed at life regardless, okay? I have to do what's best for me, okay? So, I finally decided to take the steps and either limit or end all contact with those who don't mean me any good. So, to the people that may watch this, you know who I'm talking about. You haven't heard from me. You probably won't hear from me. It's because I've ended this whole relationship, friendship, family ship, anything, okay? I wish you well. But you're disturbing my mental peace and my family's peace. So, God bless, but you can't be in my life no more, okay? And that goes for my growth, my health, my ambitions, my dreams, and most importantly, my spiritual findings, okay? I just want y'all to know that. And yes, some people are actually only compatible with the expired version of yourself. Y'all know what that means, right? They were good for you when you were a different person. Now that you're becoming a better person, a new person, they're not compatible with you. They are not supposed to be in your life. They're not supposed to be on your journey. Wish them well. Love them. I hope they transpire in life and manifest all good things upon them. However, I do not want that energy near me in my life. Near my children, near my husband, near my marriage, or whatever. You know, seriously. Because there's people out here that's jealous of my children. They might not say it. There's people out here jealous of your marriage. They might not say it. Hey, I'm not saying I have the perfect marriage. I'm not saying I got the perfect kids. We all go through stuff. However, to me, God have them perfect in my eyes. Yes, they mess up. I know when they mess up. I get on to all of them when they mess up. But they're perfect in my eyes, okay? So, yeah. As I was saying, sorry, baby has joined. Baby stinks. like I was saying about the whole expired version, you know, compatible with the old you or whatever. It's a part of growth. That's all it is, you know. Growing up, realizing, yeah, it's not for me. They're not for me. You know, I'm not for them. And it's okay. It's all right. I mean, it'll get easier as the time goes. Sorry, daddy's changing baby in camera. It'll get easier as the time goes. So remember that, just stay strong. You know, live for you. Live for today. Tomorrow isn't promised for no one. You know, people dying every day. So just live for you and be happy for you. And who's to say that God won't change these friends or family's lives and they become different people and you guys rekindle down the road? Who's to say? Nobody. We can never tell what the future holds. But yeah. And to those so-called family and friends that's not supporting me on this journey, it's okay. I forgive you. But just know, when the gun tribe make it to the top, and we will make it to the top, trust me, we will make it to the top. Y'all hearing it from me. When we make it there, don't circle back around. Please don't. Don't come back around, okay? Don't have your hand out at all. I will help those that are in need. I will help those who God placed in my life for me to help. I will help those who have supported me. That is all. And I will make sure I get my tithes. But other than that, don't come back around. Please don't. Please don't come back around. Okay? Seriously. You know what's crazy is, I used to crave to be accepted and loved by family and friends who wouldn't even give me a crumb off their plate. I used to crave it. Like, I used to want to be accepted and loved. Like, I wanted you to invite me somewhere. I wanted you to say I was your friend. I wanted you to say I was your family. I wanted you to say I love you. I wanted you to say I care. Whole time, you didn't. And it's okay. It's all right. But that's the crazy part. You know, now that I look at today versus how I was then, and I'm like, man, I have changed. And I don't want my kids to feel like they have to be like that. You don't have to have nobody love you or care for you. As long as your mama, daddy, and most importantly, God love and care for you, that is all that matters. That is all that matters. So, don't get me wrong. It's not easy losing and letting go of people that you really care for, but you have to. In order for you to get better in life and for you to be healthier mentally, physically, emotionally, spiritually, you have to get those people out of your life who don't mean you no good. And it will be hard, but eventually you will be able to do it, I promise. Every day I roll with the punches that life throws at me, but I remain strong, I remain solid, faithful, and humble. That is it. That is how I have to do, you know, be in order for me to elevate in life. Speaking of elevate, everything in life consists of evolution as well as elevation. And with elevation comes what? Separation. So remember, as you elevate, things will separate. And things that are meant to be in your life and come together will come together as those things that need to be separated will be. So yeah, I hope you guys have a great day. This is the end of that discussion that I really wanted to discuss. You know, I know a lot of people are dealing with the same thing, but I do want you guys to know that I love you guys. Thank you for those who are supporting me. Thank you to those who don't want to support me. It is okay. And remember, the gun tribe will make it. You hearing it from the mama bear herself. Is there something, Mr. Gun?
Everybody have a good day. And happy Sunday.
All right. And is there something you would like to say, Miss Italy Gun Tribe?
Oh.
How you doing? How you living?
What's up?
How you doing? How you feeling? How you living, Haley?
What's up?
You tired, Rosie?
I'm mad at you.
Zachariah, sorry you guys, I don't know where my baby is. I really don't. Look, how you doing? How you feeling? How you living? Say what's up? What's up? What's up? What's up? And the girls have their friend cousin over. This is Kyrie. How you doing? How you feeling? How you living?
What's up?
All right, y'all have a. We will be vlogging later on.